Okay, continuing on with the Rotating Sky Explorer, I wanted to show you now, instead of, we're going to be at the same latitude, remember we're at 41 degrees north, and you can tell that again by the angle above the northern horizon, or the altitude above the horizon that the North Celestial Pole is. So Polaris, again, is at 41 degrees north, so we know our latitude is 41 degrees north. If you didn't know that, of course, it's written right there on the in the simulator. Now let's go ahead and, instead of putting a star on our northern horizon, let's put a star on our eastern horizon from this location. Again, we can see the altitude, you know, it's around zero, it's on my horizon, and which horizon? 90 degrees azimuth. So that's my eastern horizon. Those are my altitude and azimuth values. Notice that the declination and right ascension values are different. My declination is zero. That means that star is right on the celestial equator. Again, to put my labels on, notice that, yes, that makes sense. My star is right on the celestial equator. It's neither above nor below, so it's got a declination of zero. Now its right ascension, remember that the right ascension starts at where the zero-hour circle intersects the celestial equator and goes eastward. And so the right ascension of this star is about 23.5 hours, because it's almost 24 hours around is the position of that. So that, those are the declination and right ascension values for this star. Now what's going to happen to the star when I start the animation? Let's check it out. See it? Start. And notice that, okay, 6 hours later, boom, my star is no longer on my eastern horizon. In fact, it's high in my southern sky. If I wanted to specify the location, I would say it's got an altitude of 49 degrees and it's got an azimuth of 180. This is my southern sky. Check out the right ascension and declination values. They haven't changed. And so now I go another 6 hours. And boom, my star is on my western horizon. I just set. So notice this is a rise and set star. Now I can't see it anymore from my position. So it's got an azimuth, I'm sorry, it's got an altitude of negative 2.8. It's below my horizon. It's got an azimuth of 270. It's in my western sky. And it was in my sky for about 12 hours. Now it's going to be below my horizon for 12 hours. So this is a rise and set star. Notice again, the right ascension value, declination value, those haven't changed. Again, that position of that star is fixed on the celestial sphere. The celestial sphere only appears to move because of the rotation of the Earth. So these values have been changing wildly. These values have remained fixed. That's the difference between the horizon system and the equatorial system. Okay, so now let's check out that same star let's change our latitude. If we increase our latitude, what if I move northward a little bit? What's going to happen to that star? Well, let's try it. Okay. Now notice that star rises in my due east, climbs lower in the sky, and then sets in my due west. Again, spending about 12 hours above the horizon. It's still a rise and set star. Now what if I go all the way to the North Pole? What does that star do? Again, because it has a declination of zero, it's right on the celestial equator, and from the North Pole, the celestial equator is on the horizon. And so therefore, this star never rises nor sets. It just kind of rides right on the horizon for the entire 24 hours. So it turns out that, and you have the choice to, you can choose, you can show the circumpolar region. All the stars that have declination of zero or larger would be all circumpolar stars. I can start adding some stars. All these have positive declinations. And sure enough, from the North Pole, they are all circumpolar. They're up all the time. That's what a circumpolar star is. It's one that can be visible anytime. As I change my latitude, the number of circumpolar stars decreases. So now I'm at 22 degrees north latitude, and sure enough, if you look at my north celestial pole, it's 22.5 degrees above my northern horizon. But all those stars that I just drew are no longer circumpolar stars. They rise. They climb high in the sky, and then they set. In fact, I can add star trails to make that a little more clear, especially watching the way they rise. So they rise, move counterclockwise around the north celestial pole, and then they set. These are no longer circumpolar stars from this particular latitude. They're rise and set stars. And that's what these different bands are. You can choose circumpolar regions. You can choose the rise and set regions. So let me reset the star trails. And I'm going to show the rise and set region instead of the circumpolar region. So notice any star that has declinations from this value, which is pretty large positive declination, to this pretty large negative declination, all these are going to be rise and set stars. And then you can also see ones that are never going to rise. Stars that are down here are never going to rise. I can add a couple in this region. And notice that, yes, from this particular latitude, I'm never going to see those stars. Those stars have very large negative declinations. They're all pretty close to the south celestial pole. And sure enough, they move clockwise around the south celestial pole. And all that hopefully will give you enough information about how this simulation works for you to complete the student guide and to successfully complete the lab quiz.